next, I'll actually toggle over to tags. So we have 1,031 tags defined in this particular demonstration system. You know, and I can scroll through them. I can search for them. We've got collection. So what's the data source? What's the frequency? Is the data collection triggered versus polled? Does the protocol that's being used support unsolicited data? So very technical kind of control engineer type data. But as you're thinking about what's the likely use of the data, how am I going to use it? If I'm at the machine level or at the line level, what's the frequency of the data that I need to be able to make decisions? It's important to be thought through. You can change it, right? It's not hard coded. It's a configuration screen. So that's another piece here is thinking, you know, an off the shelf product will be configurable, will have, you know, have a rich configuration environment that's going to let you make, make some of those choices. Scaling. So maybe your tag, as I talked about, maybe you're storing the data in Fahrenheit, but, or it's coming in Fahrenheit and you really want to store it in Celsius. So do you have that ability? With, you know, with engineering units, do you have compression? So we talked about compression before. So do I want to enable compression at the calculation level? So only send data to the archiver based on a percent change. Only send the data if there's a 5% change, right? And then, well, you know what? I haven't sent any data for 5 minutes, so I'm still going to log a record every 5 minutes just so that I know that someone's doing a report or they're seeing a trend, you know, that it hasn't been too long since I've had it written an actual record to the database. And then are you going to do archive compression? Are you going to take the power that that server has to not store data, but recreate the data when it's being queried? So you don't have to store data, which reduces your disk, both disk access times, as well as the amount of data being stored on disks. Very powerful here. And so again, that could be done via percentages or absolute values. You know, what are the and then, you know, again, what is there a compression timeout? So again, capabilities you might not think you need, but actually will likely become valuable. I can't do it in this particular collector, but maybe you want calculations, right? Maybe you want to combine tags, or maybe you want complex scaling calculations, or you want to, you know, combine multiple tags into a tag, right? So the ability for you to do that in the system without necessarily having to go back to the control system and put math in that controller, nobody wants to do that, right? What you want to be doing is calculating the data, you know, at the sort of lowest level possible in the organization so that every user has visibility to a consistent data set.